black student had a stroke inside of the school. Black student tells the nurse, hey, this is what's happening to me. I need help. What does the nurse do? Well, in my medical opinion, you don't need help. I'm gonna call your mom. Put up the picture of the mom and the student who had a stroke. Okay, let me give you some background. That's a 17-year-old Boston High School student, suffered a stroke while in class, did not receive the medical attention he needed. Instead, the chief medical personnel decided to call his mother instead of 911. His name is D’Andre Hicks, a junior at Henderson Inclusion Upper School in Dorchester. That's his mother, Alicia, all right? After telling his school nurse he felt weak, shaky, and numb, she called his mother, Ms. Hicks, to pick him up from the school, ignoring the signs, ignoring them completely, suggesting the child was having a stroke and the mother's request to get more immediate assistance to her child. So literally, you have a nurse who's so engaged in this either hyper aggression bias or implicit bias. It doesn't matter which one. And I say this often, it feels the same to the other, to the person on the other side of it, right? What this person still received no care. The mother said, listen, can we do something quick? It's gonna take me a minute to get there. Can we provide some help faster? No. We just need to get here as soon as you can. All right? While the 17-year-old child is having a stroke at the school. She recalled the nurse telling her, he's going to die if he's stroking. They're taking too long to dial 911. That's what the mother said. Sounds more astute than a medical professional. Put up the mother and the 17-year-old child again, D’Andre. Okay, remember, this is a student. This student depends on adult administrators to do their jobs, especially those in the medical profession. As I've said before, when you work in those school systems, your number one job, your first obligation is to the safety of the student. Your second is in the academic development, and third is the social development, which includes morality, ethics, etc. His mother argues the school's top medical professional should have considered first responders who would have gotten to the boy first, noting her proximity to the school and inability to move fast because she is confined to a wheelchair. Okay, the school was aware of this. This is how the nurse responded. The nurse told the mom, well, in my professional, my medical evaluation, it doesn't look like he needs an ambulance. Somebody should come and pick him up. Eventually, the school did call 911. They arrived damn near 45 minutes later after the initial call to the mother. So you're talking about maybe an hour plus of time this kid is having a stroke and suffering, okay? Once an ambulance showed up, now there's more. The young man was taken to Tufts Medical Center where he was diagnosed as having a stroke. The doctor stopped the stroke using medication, but had to hospitalize the 17-year-old for 2 days, okay? The family actually has a history of strokes. She doesn't understand how the nurse did not recognize the very obvious symptoms of a stroke. Let me show you the superintendent. Put up the picture of the superintendent. That's the superintendent. Her name is Brenda Casilius, who has since reached out to the mother and apologized. All right, so she saw, I'm so sorry that we have a culture of bias in our system. Apparently the school released a statement to parents about the paramedics coming to the campus, but instead of referencing D’Andre's stroke, the 17-year-old, they said that the ambulance were called to support a student having a diabetic episode. They lied. Well, guess what? We're setting the record straight here. So, to all of the parents at this school, every single one of you, this is where you get the true story. The letter you got was a lie. The young man was not having a diabetic episode, he was having a stroke. And that school nurse that your children depend on, that you depend on, could have led, her actions could have led to the death of D’Andre. The mother believes that race played a part into this. I agree with the mother. Her thoughts about race and medical care are in line with a recent study put out by the American Bar Association about implicit bias and racial disparities in healthcare. They claim black people simply are not receiving the same quality of healthcare that their white counterparts receive. Her son is evidence of this, all right? This is being investigated at this point. There's no word about the family filing a civil rights lawsuit. I do hope they will file a civil rights lawsuit. We expose these stories, number one, for the sake of truth, clarity. Number two, to become an advocate for those who are true victims. And number three, to provide pressure for transformation to happen, all right? AB, thoughts about this?
I definitely agree that the mom should file a civil rights lawsuit. I mean, this is intentional negligence at its finest, right? The school has a duty of care to care for that child and to make sure that he is taken care of with proper medical care when he does have an emergency. There should be something in his file to support any, you know, medical issues he may have. But I mean, we've seen nurses be convicted for less, right, for accidents. This was intentional. Period. It was intentional. And this is one of the issues, as mentioned, with black people in healthcare. They never believe us. We're just supposed to be so strong and, you know, be on the brink of death before we get help. And it's ridiculous. We got to improve our system and we got to stand together. So I do hope that mother stands up for her son and gets justice from that school.
I provide lectureships for Morehouse School of Medicine on the social side. And we had data that came out roughly 4, maybe 5 years ago that was conclusive. And the data showed that if you are a black person and you have a white doctor, your chances of living a long life statistically decreases. If you are a black person with a black doctor, you have an increased viability of life. That's connected to the social dynamic associated with medical care. That black doctors listen to black patients in ways that white doctors dismiss them. So that becomes a great disconnect. The data was clear. That data is available for anybody's review. Okay.